Hey, you're listening to Marketing Out Loud, a daily podcast where I share advice, stories, and insights to help you build a thriving consulting or professional services practice. To subscribe to the show, head over to marketingoutloud.fm. It's interesting when inspiration strikes. It's almost never a convenient time. And I've learned that the hard way in recording this daily podcast, which I think up until now, this episode is, I think we're in the 80s or 90s. We're pushing 100. So I've now got a lot of experience creating content. I had a lot of experience creating content before this, but now I've got even more. And I've learned a thing or two about when inspiration strikes. The first thing I've learned is you never really know when it's going to strike. It's not something that you can really control. Like when I started this podcast, initially the idea was I'd record an episode every single morning when I first sit down at my desk. And that happened for about a week. And then that went out the window. And it just, you know, just that wasn't the right flow for me. I think part of it is because when I'm in the morning, I'm just not in a content production kind of mood in the morning. Part of it is I quit drinking coffee, so I didn't have that buzz in the morning. Part of it is I moved to a co-work space, so I don't have the privacy of my own office like I used to in my home office. Number of reasons, but I just didn't feel like, you know, it was coming to me first thing in the morning every single day. What I did find was inspiration would come in bursts. So I'd have a bunch of ideas for episodes. I have to scribble them down and then record them in one big batch. And it would just flow that way. Or something would happen during the day. I'd have a call. I'd have an experience. I would watch something or listen to something. I'd have an idea and I'd have to record that right away. And that's how probably 90% of these episodes get recorded. Either I have a string of ideas and I batch them all together and I just go through them one by one, or I have one moment of inspiration and I've got to record it right away. And I have, you know, for the 80 or 90, you know, episodes I've done so far, I probably have another 100 ideas that are in my Evernote folder that have not gotten recorded and never will get recorded because I made note to come back to them later. I documented them for later. But once that moment's gone, I lose the message. I lose the inspiration for that message. And now when I look at that folder, I look at those ideas, I'm sure there's good ideas in there, but I'm not really sure what they were anymore. I've lost that idea. And so the reason I share this with you is because if you're a content producer, trick question, by the way, you have to be a content producer. If you're not a content producer in today's marketplace, you are invisible. Okay, so that was a trick question. You are a content producer. But to be an effective content producer, you have to know when inspiration tends to arrive. So you can be prepared for it and embrace it and channel it in a positive direction. Right now, for example, I mentioned this yesterday. Yesterday, because yesterday's episode I recorded right before this one in the same car ride. I am coming off an 17-hour fast. It's 8:54 p.m. right now. I had a kickboxing class. And I went home and I got in the shower, and in the shower, I had five episodes ideas just come to me in the shower. You know, the shower tends to do that. The endorphins from the exercise, I'm sure, helped. And the fact that I'm on an empty stomach, combined with the endorphins from the exercise and the shower, just gave me this like super like ninja clarity of focus in the shower. And then bang, all these episode ideas just came to me. And now I'm driving to my in-laws for dinner, and I'm trying to hammer them out as fast as possible before I lose the inspiration. That's how it works for me. Anyways, a lot of times it just comes at once like a waterfall, and I've got to hit record and I've got to go. And usually it happens when I'm driving, because that's when I have, you know, 20 to 30 minutes of uninterrupted time to just hit record on my phone and go at it. But that's me. That's one way it happens. The other way it happens, like I mentioned, is I'll be on a call, or I'll finish a podcast interview, or I'll listen to a podcast, or I'll see something and I'll immediately just want to comment on it. And then I'll just hop into a meeting room, or I'll go for a walk and I'll hit record and I'll talk about that topic. That's how it works for me for this podcast. I want you to think about how inspiration tends to arrive for you, for whatever medium of content you're creating. I'm sure you're not creating a daily podcast, so obviously it's going to look different for you. But if you're writing long form articles, if you're recording videos, which is a great thing to do, I encourage you to do that. If you are recording some kind of a podcast, whatever your medium is, I want you to think about, well, when do ideas tend to come to me? Because ideas, you know, ideas are a lot like leads, right? Leads go stale after a while, right? Lead sends you an email on day one. You know, if you get back to them within a day or two, that's fine. If it takes you a week, then that lead tends to go stale. Ideas are much the same. When ideas come to you, and they're fresh, then they're really hot and they're really live and they have a lot of potential and you can do a lot with them. But when you sit on them and you let them go stale, then they tend to lose their value, tend to lose their life. So I want you to think about, when do ideas tend to come to you, and how can you streamline a process much like I've just described to you? That's my process. But how can you streamline a process that would allow you to capitalize on those ideas when they come to you? And I want you to notice that this is not about when you release your ideas. This is not about when you produce, or rather publish your ideas. This is about when you produce your ideas. Okay, I published this episode, this podcast rather. You can tell the fast is getting to me. I'm mixing up all my words. I publish this podcast every day, but I don't record every day, right? It goes out on a schedule, but the schedule on which I produce it is very, very different. And that's perfectly fine. That's my way of building a process around when I'm at my best and then putting it into a schedule for release. You have to have your own process. So if you publish weekly videos, that's fine. You don't need to record a video every week. Maybe you take one day, and in fact, I've done this with a lot of my clients, is they've taken one day out of the month and they'll block off half a day and they'll plow through 6 to 8 videos in half a day. And then that becomes 2 months worth of video content. Or maybe you do it once a month for 1 month worth of content. Whatever works for you, think about what that looks like, when inspiration strikes, how can you build a process around that and get this done as easily as possible? Because the truth is, guys, producing content is hard. If you've tried it, you'll know that. It's difficult. It's a challenge. And the easier you can make it upon yourself by striking when the iron is hot, the better you're going to be at it, and the more you'll be able to sustain this exercise in the long run. And that's really what it's all about. Hey, thanks for listening. Do me a favor. If you like what you hear, go on iTunes and leave us a rating and a review, because it helps more people discover the show. Thanks so much.